Hey, what's going on, guys? So today we are gonna head into Home Depot. But the first thing that I wanna work on with Mabel is that she just remains calm getting out the car, all right? So we hear that she's whining a little bit, but the main rule is that she shouldn't jump out until she hears me release her, all right? So if I close the door, let's say I just got out the car, if I open that door, we want her to hold it until she hears that release. And we worked on this before, but so we can see she's doing a pretty good job. Good. But even if I go up to her and pet her, that petting is not the release. She should not release from any doorway, especially the car doorway, until she hears that release marker. Come here, Mabel. Break. Then we go. So the first thing that I want to make sure that she understands is that she's on the leash. Because that main rule with her being on the leash is that she must follow me. So like there, good. She kind of wasn't, she was checking out, but she caught herself really quick. I'm gonna give her some free time. Free dog. One big thing is if we're gonna be taking our dogs into stores or patios or just inside places, definitely make sure you give the dog a chance, an opportunity to use the bathroom first. We don't want the embarrassing mistake of bringing our dog somewhere and them using the bathroom in that inside area. Let's go. And so now I see that Home Depot has these little carts, so I want to help her, or I want to see if she will go up there for me. Good girl. Good. Good girl. Good. Then I'm gonna give her one more opportunity to use the bathroom. Wait. Free dog. So this trip is at least my first time with Mabel coming to Home Depot or inside of any store. So I'm gonna take things nice and slow. The main thing that I want is for her to just get that exposure. So I'm not gonna be working on too many obedience positions this time. I just want her to walk through Home Depot and understand that the only thing that she has to worry about doing is following me. And then as we do it more, then I can ask her to do the heels and the walk between my legs and the sits and the downs in Home Depot, because it's not such a strange place anymore. She's been here a couple of times. With me. So now I've told her with me, which means I want her to walk right on my hip. I think we're actually gonna go in through the gardening side. Let's go. So now I've told her let's go, and that pretty much just means she has the full leash. The gardening side is a little less busy than inside, so I'm gonna take advantage of there being smells around, but her still being checked in with me. Good girl. You wanna make sure that you throw that duration marker at her, good girl, because she loves that sound, and she also understands that that sound means to keep it up. Good girl. Mm-hmm. go. So we see she's getting freaked out. There's some machinery up here. And it's just different. So she doesn't know how to act around it. So again, I'm not gonna ask her to do anything. I want her to just see stuff. If I ask her to give me a position in that, then it turns into some conflict because, again, she doesn't want to do it. She's around a strange machine that she's never been around before, and it came really, really close to her with me. Thank you. So there was a pretty good interaction with a person. As I, like I told her, Mabel's just very freaked out right now. So the main thing that we want is for her to just get that exposure. I'm actually not gonna let anybody else really interact with her. I just want to see how she did in that interaction. We'll build up to her being nice and loose in busy areas. But right now it's tough because, like I said, this is new for her. Remember. Again, the only rule is to pay attention to me, which she is pretty soon gonna stop doing. This area is nice and quiet, so I'm gonna take advantage and do something that's familiar to her. Girl, yes. Yeah, so she doesn't even want that food right now. Let's go. So now she's calmed down. Good girl. Yeah, but again, we're in an area where there's not anything going on at all. We're just around a bunch of doors. So I want to bring something that's familiar, and then we'll go to an aisle where maybe a smidge more exciting than this aisle. But I want to make sure that she's a good girl, just completely understands the concept of first, this, let's go, and then next we'll work on the with me. Says, okay, we're gonna go that way. And then I just say, hey, nope, we're going this way today. Good girl. Thank you. Let's go. So it's all going to be about repetition. Now we go back to the basics. A little busier aisle. You can see she's freaked out. But we just go back to the basics. Again, it's going to take repetition. A lot of first communicating with her of how we want her to react. And then two, just repeating. So now we can see she's kind of checked back in to what she knows. With me. Now I'm going to go shorter leash. Good. Good. And now we'll go to a slightly busier area. No, sit. Let's go. So it's not her being defiant or anything. She's just very, very confused. Sit. No. Good. Let's go. Let's go. Sit. Good. So one thing about the leash tension is it's very, very good for me right now because she's in a mood where she doesn't even want to take the food. So because I've been able to communicate with her using my leash, even when I need her to sit or in a second we'll try to get her to go into a down, and she will hold the position because I'm able, or even go into the position because I'm able to use a little bit of leash tension. So like right now, I'm gonna go, Mabel, lay down. Leash tension towards the ground. Good girl. Good. She's just able to understand, all right, when I hear that sound and then when I feel this tension with this leash in this direction, it means to do that behavior. All right. So, again, that's a main reason why I like to teach leash tension, luring, and shaping so that we don't always depend on our dog needing that food or needing that leash to listen to us. Good girl. Break. Wait. Let's go. Wait. Sit. Let's go. No, no. With me. Good girl. Let's go. Mabel, sit. Thank you. Thank you so much. So that was our Home Depot trip. If I were to rate that out of 10, I would give her a solid 5. Again, not because she did anything bad, but she was just very, very underexposed. So what we're gonna start focusing on is coming back to Home Depot. And we're gonna do that same exact thing again a couple times. And then we're gonna turn it into, now she's been there a few times, so she's able to check in with me a little more, and then we'll start doing some obedience there. So again, that was a good solid first trip. Was able to give me the chance to assess and see where we are. Like I said, I feel like she's a 5 out of 10, and being in a very, very excited or stimulated area like that. And we're gonna work our hardest to get her to that 10 out of 10. All right, so once again, good girl, Mabel. She's gonna go home and KO. And you guys have a great day.